Weigh anchor and hoist the sail.
Hi, this is Craig, and welcome back to Cruising Off Duty. This is an exciting time. I'm, 2.5 days away from flying off to South Africa, getting on that catamaran, and sailing 10,000 nautical miles across the South Atlantic, the equator, the Caribbean, all the way to the East Coast of the United States. It's going to be epic, and there's going to be so many great episodes in the future, so subscribe if you haven't already to follow along. I want to give you that heads up again. It's probably the channel's going to go black for a while once I go, because let's face it, when I'm in the middle of the South Atlantic on a boat, I can't exactly upload 5 gigabyte videos every 2 or 3 days. So a lot of it's going to be me collecting footage and bringing my laptop, which I'll show you in a second, and then paring down the good stuff from the not so good stuff so that I don't run out of hard drive space, because I'm going to bring like 4 hard drives, but you know, well, shooting 4K or anything like that over an extensive period of time, you just blow through hard drives like you won't believe. So I'm going to review all the footage at the end of every day, and I'm going to make file folders that are going to say this is day one's footage, and then when I get somewhere where I can actually edit and upload, then I'll start putting out episodes. But worst case scenario, it could be at the very end of the 8 weeks. And so I don't want anybody to worry like the channel went black and there's no episodes for 2 months. People think I've given up on YouTube. It's not that. It's probably that I have no internet. So there you go. So I'm going to show you the camera gear and the stuff that I'm going to bring on this voyage. Some of it I'm just not going to be able to fit. And so I've got to make decisions right now or tonight what I'm going to bring, because this is the backpack I'm going to bring. This is the new, I guess it's called a Terion backpack. It's a professional camera gear backpack, and it's got so many pouches and things. In fact, this big area here is actually fits this smaller camera bag that actually fits inside it. But I'm thinking that's a waste of space to have a camera bag inside a camera bag, and space is definitely going to be at a premium. So I think I'm just going to put some of these dividers in the middle and use the space more efficiently. But like I say, brand new bag, haven't even used it yet. It's got so many pouches. Even got a spot for a full-size tripod like this one. This is a carbon fiber tripod, so it's fairly light with just a fluid ball head on it, not my big ball head that I'm using right now on the camera that we're filming on. But even this is probably going to end up in my suitcase, because I can't see myself getting on a plane with this on my backpack and trying to swing it around and put it in the overhead compartment without sculling some poor lady with this thing flying around on the side of it. So probably just to not overwhelm the people when I get on the plane, this will probably go in a suitcase. And generally the rule I'm going to have is anything I can't live without is going in that backpack. That's going to be my main camera, my backup camera, at least one or maybe two of my GoPros, my vlog camera. And then I'm going to start paring down with stuff I don't necessarily need, but I would like to have there, is going to go in my suitcase. So yeah, so let's see what makes it in the backpack and what doesn't. And just so you know, I'll probably have all this in the backpack by tomorrow, and tomorrow is going to be a live episode. So tomorrow, the 14th of May, I'm going to do a live episode. Janice will be there as well. You can ask us any questions. It's going to be a live Q&A before I go kind of episode. Janice is going to be there because some people always have questions about what Janice thinks about me taking off for a 10,000 nautical mile sailing voyage when she's not going. Yeah, let you ask her that at the time live. Any other questions you can think of between now and then, ask them in the live episode. And when I get a question that's really good, Janice is going to be my scribe. She's going to write down the best questions so that later, because not everybody watches the live episodes, they're kind of sometimes end up being longer than most people would like, maybe an hour long. So those questions often don't get out to the mass viewing public. So I'm going to save the best questions for future episodes on the voyage. I'm going to try and do at least one question a day called Question of the Day, and I'm going to name the person that gave me the question, and I'm going to answer it in a future episode. So I've already gotten a bunch of email questions. I've already gotten questions in the comments that are great. I've already started making a list of questions. But your last chance before I go will be this live episode tomorrow. So have your questions ready and fire at us live and hear our answers live. And I'll keep the best for future episodes as well. So let me switch to the other side of the camera and show you all the gear I have on this table. And you'll probably figure it out. I'm not going to fit it all in that backpack. Okay, let's start from left to right. Let's start at the top. This camera here, my G7X Mark II, has been my vlogging camera of choice for the last, 2 years. And as you can see, there's usually a little shutter that closes and opens when the power goes on and off. But it's, it's been broken, abused. When I was in Spain, I got some sand in it, and it never worked right after that. So I had to glue it open, so in case you're wondering. This is an awesome vlog camera. If you know the camera, it flips up so you can see yourself. The audio is very good, the low light capability is very good, and this looks silly, but it actually keeps out the wind noise. So this is my vlog camera. And what you tend to do is keep this on a on a small tripod like this when you want to go into a restaurant or a bar or something and you want to film yourself, but you don't want it to be too obvious so people don't tell you to leave. This is the camera I use. Those are the chargers for the batteries for it, and I've got a duplicate. So I'm going to bring two in case, heaven forbid, in the middle of the ocean, one of the chargers stops working. You don't want to have no batteries. Let's move on down. This is just the case for that vlog camera. This is Sony lenses. The reason you're not seeing a Sony camera is because that's what I'm filming on right now, the A7 III. Just because it has to be close to the cord, it's kind of out of order. This is just my drone battery charging, and I've charged the controller because I want to start it up and make sure I have the latest firmware before I go. And since we're talking about what drone I'm bringing, I'll flip across to my drone. That is the Mavic Pro. Now I have the Mavic 2 Pro that I own already, but I'm going to bring my old Mavic Pro because it does excellent footage, but it's also the drone that I won't use around here. And if I lose it because customs in South Africa won't let me have it, or heaven forbid it falls in the ocean and I lose it, I won't be as heartbroken to lose my secondary drone that I would if I lost my main drone. So that's why that's the drone I'm bringing. So going back over here, so there's the Sony batteries for the Sony camera. Going up there, that is my backup camera. That is my Panasonic GH5. It is an excellent, excellent camera. One good thing I like about that camera on this trip is it does in-body time-lapse. It actually takes still photos of whatever time frame you want. It takes the photos and then turns it into an actual MP4 movie when you're done, which is great. The Sony doesn't do that. It just takes the photos in a time-lapse, and then you have to go into Lightroom or one of these other software programs in order to make the actual video time-lapse, which is kind of an extra step and kind of a pain in the butt. So I'm glad Panasonic does it in camera. Now you can see I have a Panasonic GH5. I also have the older Panasonic GH4, which was my first camera. I won't probably have time or space to bring both, so the GH5 will be my backup camera. Everything on this trip has to have a backup. I've got multiple GoPros, I'm going to have multiple cameras, because heaven forbid in the middle of the ocean your main camera stops working, you just don't want to have no camera. So since I'm going to have the Panasonic, I need to have the Panasonic lenses too. Obviously I've got the one that's on there, the 11-16, I got the 17-50. And I've got this super wide angle lens that's on the GH4 right now. Those are probably the lenses I bring. If I have to cancel one of the lenses, it'll be the one that's on the GH4, since I already have wide angle lenses for my Sony. And then just to the right, nothing really unusual. You know, the mini tripods. I'm gonna have the main tripod that you saw that was on top of the, on the side of the bag, but that'll be things for time lapses or things where you're gonna leave the camera for a while. That's what that'll be for. If you're vlogging or doing anything else, you need these little bendy tripods. Moving to the right, this is just a top-mounted, cold shoe mounted camera, LED light for any camera I use. It's in here, it's rechargeable. It's a great little thing, doesn't take up much space, so I'll bring that. Of course, one of my favorite additions is a travel gimbal. This is the Weeble Lab. It's nice and small and compact. It locks down, it's not locked right now, but it'll lock into one axis, so it doesn't take up a lot of space. And yeah, it's really good. I've turned down the sensitivity so it moves slower than it did from the factory, and I've been really happy with that. This thing here is the wireless lavalier microphones. I'm wearing one right now. This is the secondary transmitter, so I'll have the ability to record two people simultaneously when I record. I'm going to be doing two factory tours when I get to South Africa, one at the Maverick factory and one at the Exquisite factory. So that'll be a perfect time to use two transmitters, because I'll put one on the guide that's going to be showing me around and one on me so you can hear my questions, and that should work out perfectly. I saw it earlier today, but I don't know what I did with my shotgun microphone, my Azden SMX30, I think it's called. It's a shotgun microphone that has stereo and mono. It was on this table earlier today and I must have walked away with it. There's more stuff on the table over there that I'm trying to go through to decide what I need. So I don't know what I did with it, but it's around here somewhere. Okay, going down here is my two sort of computers, one for consumption, one for editing. This is my iPad 12.9 inch. You could actually edit your videos right on this. You could definitely edit photos on this. I've never bothered because I've always had the 13 inch MacBook. So yeah, this is gonna be what I edit on, or at least compile the footage and decide what I'm going to keep and what I'm not going to keep, and maybe do some entries like first cut editing. I'll probably do the final cut editing when I get somewhere with a really, really good computer, like the one I have here in my house, the MacBook or the Mac Pro. This is my consumption. So this is where I watch TV, movies, read a magazine, do whatever. The reason I do it on this and not on the laptop is A, it's just easier to carry around. B, it's a lot easier on battery power. Now on this fancy schmancy catamaran, it probably has tons of solar and generator power that battery power is not as big a deal as when you're on like my boat. But when I'm on my boat and I want to watch a movie, I'm not going to spend 2 hours watching it on this and blowing through the battery on my boat, because let's face it, it goes through this massive brick, which uses a lot of power in order to keep your MacBook charged. The iPad charges on very little amperage, so it doesn't really blow through your boat battery to use that. Now over here again is the drone. This is the drone case that I usually use if I'm just driving around locally and I want to bring my drone. It has all the cutout compartments. Let me open it for you. So there you go. As you can see, everything's perfectly cut out into this nice sturdy foam. This is what I like. You just throw everything that you need in there, close it, latch it, you're good to go. Throw it in the back of your car. Nothing can happen through this is going to damage your drone. But as you can see, trying to pack this inside that, what a waste of space, right? Like this will take up half the backpack right there. So I have another way that I often do when I'm doing hiking or anything. If I want to take my drone with me, it goes in these clamshell cases. So you've got this one that really just fits the drone. So that drone will fit in here. And then this one's just for your controller. And if you need a spare battery on other than the one that's already in your drone, you just bring it separately in a pocket of your backpack. And there we go. And then you'll just see the random batteries. I've always been the type that I hate buying like regular Duracells and then blowing through them and throwing them in the garbage. It's bad for the environment. And let's face it, it's bad for the pocketbook too. So I've always used rechargeables. This is my fancy schmancy rechargeable battery system. It's really great. It's digital. It tells you everything about the how good your batteries still are, percentages of this, that, the other thing. Unfortunately, again, size is the problem. It's pretty big, so I might have to go back to just a basic charger where, you know, plug it in your battery and the little light goes on and tells you it's charging, and then when it's done and light goes off. It's not nearly as sophisticated, but it is, you know, it'll do the job. These batteries, these slightly bigger batteries, they're called 1650 batteries, are what things like my gimbal use. So I need to bring these as well, and that's maybe one argument for bringing that charger, because it charges anything you throw in there. AA, AAA, 1650. If it makes contact between the positive and negative, that thing will figure out what it is and give it the right amount of voltage. So yeah, I really love that thing. So if I can fit it, might go in the suitcase, since I can't probably fit it everything in the backpack. That might be something I just toss in the suitcase. And if I lose it in the travel in the airport, which I always assume I will, then it's not the end of the world. Okay, so as you can see, it's gonna be tough to fit everything, including some stuff that's back there that I didn't even get a chance to show you, into this one backpack. I forgot to mention though, I do plan, because I think you are allowed to have two carry-on items. This is actually considered one carry-on item, even though it's quite large. I'm gonna bring a second, what's called a sling bag. So this will be over my shoulder on my front, and that will be over the shoulder on my back. I know I'm gonna look like a camel that's being loaded down with everything somebody owns. But that's what you got to do when you want to carry everything of value with you on the plane and you don't trust the checked luggage system. So wish me luck. It's a 26-hour flight and I leave in 2.5 days. So I don't have a lot of time to get all this stuff organized and packed, but hopefully I get most of it done before the live episode tomorrow. Hopefully you'll tune in, ask me any questions, find out. Hopefully this will be full to the gills and you'll find out how much I was able to fit in this thing. And yeah, talk to you then. Until next time, this is Craig signing off, wishing you safe cruising, and ciao for now.
We anchor and hoist the sail. We're chasing